You see that?
T-Swift, everybody.
That is 100% Taylor Swift. Yeah, I think that girl's gonna do some amazing things.
The future's bright.
Yeah. I don't want that thing slipping in there again. Welcome to one of the last videos that is shot in the same space as the storage space.
One of the last?
I mean,
you're getting so ahead of yourself.
Last couple months. I know, I'm so excited for the new space. We got a bunch of cheap gaming microphones, the budget option from every company. We got three from pretty large notariable companies. We got Razer, HyperX, and Blue over here. And then I always get a bajillion tweets asking me to review this teeny tiny little like knockoff, not name brand microphone. And so I grabbed the one that seemed to have the best reviews out of all of them, which is the fifine 5150, I think it's called. So we're gonna check these out. We're gonna see which budget ones are the best. Budget microphones, budget USB microphones are interesting. I don't understand how you can fit a microphone, a preamp, and a, my brain just disappeared. And a converter all into a single microphone. And make it $50 or $35 in this case and have it still sound good. But the really low end ones always have like a couple consistencies between them. For example, all four of these lack a headphone jack. Don't expect to be able to hear your own voice in your headset. If that's something you like to do like I like to do, it's not gonna happen. If you don't mind, then these might be good options for you. Whenever you watch these videos, I feel like there's always a couple specs that are talked about, for example, like sample rate. Some of these can go to like 44.1. Some of them are like, oh, this one goes all the way up to 48 kilohertz sample rate.
Yeah, that doesn't make a difference.
It doesn't matter.
No. I mean, as an audio professional, I am always an advocate of higher audio quality, but in terms of practical application, that the sample rate differences are not gonna matter.
Do you think the polar pattern will matter? Because like this one is a cardioid and this one's a hypercardioid.
Yes, polar pattern will potentially make a big difference in terms of how much background noise you hear or keyboard noise.
It's good we got a keyboard.
Yeah, that's a common issue people run into, you know, noisy family, noisy neighbors, or their keyboard or their controller is just clicking a lot in the microphone. So
let's give them a shot then.
Yeah.
Let's start with the Razer Siren Mini. We tested this one in a video a little bit ago. If you want to watch it, we'll link it down below. And it was one of my favorites for the price. So we're going to start with this one and then we're going to A-B it against every single other mic and see which one sounds the best. Before we get started on this bad boy, I'd like to thank the sponsor of today's video. You all know who it is, Owned.tv. Owned.tv is your one-stop shop for all your stream aesthetic needs, whether it be overlays, alerts, panels, profile pictures. If you need it, they have it. Plus, all their overlays are modular. So for example, if you and all your friends pick up this Alpha Gaming overlay you're looking at right now, which was made in conjunction with this channel, none of you guys are gonna have the same overlay because you can pick and choose the different pieces that you want and build your own overlay out of the design. If you'd like to make the smart move like many from the community have done, feel free to use the link in the description down below. That also supports the channel. So thank you. And if you'd like to save 40% at checkout, make sure you use code Alpha. Cool. Plus, oh, by the way, jump into my Twitch chat if you have any questions about these. Or Ryan's. Links to both down in the description below. If you have any questions, maybe we missed in this. But let's talk about this guy. Let's move these ones. The Razer Siren Mini. I thought I was really gonna hate this microphone when we first tested it because I tried the original Razer Siren X, which is $30 more than this, and I hated it. So I don't know how they managed to make a microphone cheaper and sound way better because this thing actually sounds great. Plus, it's pink. And I really like that. But let's take a listen, just so you know what we're up against. We're gonna do a couple tests on each of these. First thing we're gonna test, I'm gonna show you how it sounds close to the mouth, and I'm gonna show you how it sounds far away from the mouth, which is probably the biggest difference you can possibly find, which is why I picked up one of these. This is a microphone stand that clamps to the desk. I think I got it for like $14 on Amazon. One of the best upgrades you can get for your microphone. Get yourself a super cheap microphone stand. Just to give you an example of what this sounds like at the different distances, this is what the microphone sounds like at pretty much a standard distance that if you were to have it sitting on your desk while you were streaming, this is where you'd have it at. versus if I were to put it on a stand and I were to move it closer to my mouth, you're going to get a lot less room sound, you're going to get a lot less people shouting sound, and you're going to get a lot less keyboard sound. So, for example, if I'm playing a game hitting WASD while I'm talking versus what it sounds like if I'm playing a game hitting WSD while I'm talking and it's this close to my mouth. You hear the difference? For $50, this thing is a solid microphone. I still have no idea how they did this well on a microphone this cheap. Let's move on to the next one.
All right, this is the Blue Snowball Ice. You probably recognize this. I feel like it's been around for a long time, potentially older than some of the content creators watching this video. The OG, it's an old one, but it's a good one. Yeah, it's pretty cheap. $50, I think. Yeah, $50. I don't know if we need this, but right now it came with this nice little tripod stand. I believe it also comes with this massive thing that looks like it comes out of Star Wars or something. Do we have that? If I was using this on stream, I don't know if I would ever use this just because it is intense.
You know this?
Yeah, this this thing.
It doesn't come with that, by the way.
Oh, it doesn't? Separate. Okay. Yeah. Well, they do advertise these as also being appropriate for vocal recording, which I've never tried, and I'm a little skeptical, but maybe this is more for that application. A proper shock mount that just looks like you're part of the Empire. So let's go ahead and A-B this against the Razer Siren. Johnny took his place at the back of the court. It was his turn to serve. Johnny took his place at the back of the court. It was his turn to serve. Johnny took his place at the back of the court. It was his turn to serve. Johnny took his place at the back of the court. It was his turn to serve. But before he could toss the ball, his coach called a timeout. But before he could toss the ball, his coach called a timeout. But before he could toss the ball, his coach called a timeout. But before he could toss the ball, his coach called a timeout.
Did I turn off the fan between those two takes?
No, because
that did cut out a lot of background sound.
The snowball.
Yeah, the snowball did.
Yeah, which is weird, right? Because this is supposed to be super cardioid.
Did super cardioid cut out more background noise?
It cuts out definitely more of the sides. But yeah, it does start picking up a little bit of the back. Maybe that was the difference.
I feel like with the housing of this and how it's like hard on the sides, and there is like a lot more foam all built around it, I think that's cutting all that out.
Yeah.
I'm not hearing much of like a distinct quality between the two. They both sound pretty good.
Yeah, they actually sound pretty similar. Mm-hmm. I'm surprised.
That's weird because it seems like there's more keyboard clicks in the snowball.
Really?
I think so. It might just be louder. You don't hear the detail as much when it's up close.
Yeah.
They both sound really good up close, but when you get far away, you can hear the detail difference.
I definitely hear more keyboard noise in this. In the snowball.
Yeah, which is weird.
It could be that it was in the sweet spot.
Oh, like right
cancellation.
Right, not where the hypercardioid is, but yeah. right in the blank spot there.
Yeah, because you see the pattern on the graph. It comes around and it cuts in, and then there's a little bubble at the back.
Yeah. I mean, at the end of the day, as long as you have it close to your mouth, they both sound really similar.
Yeah.
And we only really started hearing a difference once it got farther away.
Yeah, so.
So they're kind of sixes.
Keep the mic close to your mouth.
Yeah, and just get, you know, if you want a pink mic, get this one.
Yeah.
That's kind of it there. All right, El Resident Cheapo. The fifine mic. This one is like, I've watched YouTube videos where people said this was their absolutely favorite mic, which is crazy because it's the cheapest mic, but it feels good. Like this doesn't feel, I want to take off this stand actually real quick. Yeah, that's like a, you want to feel it? Like that's a, like compared to this thing.
Oh, wow.
There. This thing like weighs negative pounds.
I'm just tempted to throw this one.
I want to see how much it can handle. I mean, it's definitely plastic versus this one is metal. It's got it for $35. It's got an amazing build quality. And it's also the only one with a knob. So you lose the removable cable, but you add a volume knob, which because it doesn't have a headphone jack, I assume it's got to be just microphone volume. I assume you actually have gain control on the microphone itself.
Yes, the instructions here say that controls volume of your mic, the gain. They also somehow got Taylor Swift to be in their instructional
guide. Yeah, look at that. You see that?
T-Swift, everybody.
That is 100% Taylor Swift on the fifine microphone. Yeah, I think that girl's going to do some amazing things.
The future's bright.
Yeah. However, positive part of the stand is that as we mount it on this guy, you get to keep the little angle thing. Oh yeah, and I got stuck with the, I shouldn't say I got stuck, I picked the pink ones. I don't know what it is, I like pink microphones.
Looks like you need a moment, the coach said as he handed Johnny a pair of headphones. Looks like you need a moment, the coach said as he handed Johnny a pair of headphones. Looks like you need a moment, the coach said as he handed Johnny a pair of headphones. Looks like you need a moment, the coach said as he handed Johnny a pair of headphones. Johnny slipped them over his ears and suddenly felt confidence and power return to him. Johnny slipped them over his ears and suddenly felt confidence and power return to him. Johnny slipped them over his ears and suddenly felt confidence and power return to him. Johnny slipped them over his ears and suddenly felt confidence and power return to him.
Huh, yeah, this sounds like super low-end heavy when it's close, and then it sounds overly thin when it's far.
Yeah.
This one sounds more balanced
on both. Yeah, let's see. Keep it on. Let's hear the keyboard clickiness.
Good old trusty Siren.
It's just killing it. It's great.
Yeah, it sounds good.
How is that microphone so good?
Maybe you can hear a little more keyboard in the Siren, but I think part of it is because there's so much low frequency when it's so close.
That you don't get those high-end clicks.
It's masking like everything.
Yeah, it's just a crazy proximity effect, huh? Interesting.
Let's take a look at the HyperX Solocast. First of all, they look related, but they're probably pretty different. I do like the stand that this comes with because it allows you to click and adjust the angle of the microphone. The only downside is if you want to use this with a stand like this, you have to lose this stand anyways. So you kind of lose that functionality, but kind of cool. Build quality wise, it is, again, much heavier than our light little pink pill here. Another nice feature this has is the mute button on top, which is somewhat standard in the HyperX family of microphones. And when you touch the mute button, it'll show you, it'll indicate it on this decently sized light on the front of it. Price-wise, this is the most expensive out of our microphones, but only by $10. It runs $59. And I'm excited to hear how it sounds.
Johnny tossed the ball and served up a perfect ace, winning the match. Johnny tossed the ball and served up a perfect ace, winning the match. Johnny tossed the ball and served up a perfect ace, winning the match. Johnny tossed the ball and served up a perfect ace, winning the match. The headphones were playing Stream Beats, copyright-free music for content creators on YouTube and Twitch. The headphones were playing Stream Beats, copyright-free music for content creators on YouTube and Twitch. The headphones were playing Stream Beats, copyright-free music for content creators on YouTube and Twitch. The headphones were playing Stream Beats, copyright-free music for content creators on YouTube and Twitch.
There's a lot more, again, low frequency, low mids, and mid frequencies, kind of a little, not as crazy as the fifine.
Yeah, you can hear a lot less like hum. Like this one just feels a lot like tighter. Like all you hear is the voice. I'm just always super impressed by this microphone.
You bumped the arm.
Oh really?
It was like still boom. Oh my gosh, it's listen to this.
I mean, it sounds like there's a lot of low end.
Can you hear it?
Johnny tossed the ball and served up a perfect ace.
Because I don't remember that happening while we were filming.
I don't.
It must have been, the perfect frequency to resonate in that thing.
The thing is, I moved the boom on all these microphones.
Uh-huh.
Which means this thing is super sensitive to picking up low frequencies.
Yeah.
Which also means anytime you hit the desk, anytime you move your chair, it could potentially be getting picked up in that.
Yeah, every time you move your mouse and hit it back on the desk, it's going to be grabbing that sound unless you have like a shock mount for it.
Yeah. So if you use this, you probably want to cut out. I mean, that's the thing. Like if it was for recording or whatever, like you can cut out that stuff, no problem. But
I don't even know if you can get a shock mount on this thing. I mean, I guess you can use that blue one. Man, I've never heard it like that drastic before. That was crazy.
Because it's not just when I hit it.
No, it wasn't that. It's not like it was that one time. It's like through the whole thing. Why don't we real quick record these lines again, just holding it like this. Okay. And still like, let's make note of that.
Yeah.
But let's just get the non-keyboard one and like get another recording real quick.
Johnny tossed the ball and served up a perfect ace, winning the match. Johnny tossed the ball and served up a perfect ace, winning the match.
That's all the same step. That's all low frequency rumble.
It's still rumbling? Yeah, like every little movement causes huge rumbles.
Johnny tossed the ball and served up a perfect ace, winning the match.
All of that. It's and just then, you, that's just you like touching this a little bit. I mean, I want to give him the benefit of the doubt. Maybe we got like a bad one.
Yeah, where the capsule's loose or something.
Yeah, I hope so at least. But I mean, this isn't like one that they sent me. I bought this microphone. Mm-hmm. So keep that in mind. There might be a problem with this one, but there might just be a ton of sensitivity to low end.
Did you hear the keyboard typing one? Like, was the keyboard enough to rumble the mic arm?
The headphones were playing Stream Beats.
Yeah, you hear it rumbling the whole time.
So that is on the arm. I'm not doing anything weird other than typing.
Uh-huh.
And it's just...
It's like there's an earthquake.
It's got to be something wrong with this. Like, it's got to be... I don't know.
I don't know either. I'd have to buy another one. Even like without the rumbling, I really liked this microphone.
Yeah.
Like, I think it was the best one out of all of them.
This definitely sounds the most balanced. Mm-hmm. The other ones you get extreme low end or just it sounds extreme, right? Like to me it sounds treated. This sounds pure and tight.
Yeah. Like, favorite to least favorite.
Okay. So number one would be Razer, then the Snowball Ice. I guess the fifine.
Fifine?
Fifine. And then the HyperX. But if the HyperX, if this is actually defective and that low frequency thing is not a deal, then it would be HyperX third and then the Fifine.
I 100% agree. Okay. That was my ranking as well. Chat, do you agree? What's your ranking in the description below? Which one did you like the best? Which one did you like the least? Thank you guys for watching. Hope you found this interesting. Hope you found it helpful. If you have any questions, maybe we missed, maybe you have a different experience with this thing, jump into our Twitch chats, link to both of them in the description below. And as always,
happy listening,
happy streaming,
happy listening.
See ya.